Hey there, how y'all doing? This Weapons Tech Mac coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas. And tonight, I'm coming to you from out in my old digs where I used to do all my videoing. You can see I still got some of that stuff up out there in my garage. But I haven't filmed out here, and I guess it's been close to 10 months because I moved everything out to my workshop. And since I blew out my ankle, I haven't been able to get out to my workshop. That's in the back part of my backyard. And, you know, the wheelchair ain't going to really cut it out there. But I'm going to do kind of a continuing review on the EAA Windicator or Vindicator. European American Arms. Of course, it's a German gun. You see, made in Germany. And I can't even pronounce the name of the manufacturer. I guess that's their moniker right there. I'm not good into speaking German, but I'll give you my overall thoughts on how this gun shoots. And, you know, I did a previous kind of a little review after I got it, but I wasn't able to get out and shoot it until just a couple of days ago. And just a great shout out to the gun range down in Killeen, Texas on 195. They were very accommodating to this temporarily handicapped squid. And then a shout out to my buddy Victor, who helped get me down there. And then, of course, another friend that met me there, Rick. And we just had a grand old time, you know, out there shooting and having a good time. But anyway, how did it shoot? It shot really well. I was very impressed at how this gun worked. Very accurate, soft shooting pistol. It feels good in the hand. When you're shooting 38 plus P, this is like a pop gun because it's almost 2 pounds. And so you got plenty of weight behind it, all steel revolver. Of course, it's a double action, single action, 357, 38 revolver. And I also put probably 18 rounds of full bore 357 through it. Not a problem. No hiccups. I think I shot close to 50 rounds Friday with this thing, and it was just a joy to shoot. Enjoyed it very much. Very accurate, solid pistol. Now, I know there's a lot of people out there that say this thing's a piece of junk, Saturday night special, things like that. Well, I didn't see that to be the case. This thing was a good shooter. It was reliable. Now, no, I haven't put my standard 200 rounds through it to give it the full reliability test. And that's probably not going to come until summer when I'm, for the most part, mostly mobile again. Hopefully I'll be out of this, you know, I'll be able to put some weight on this thing, being a walking boot here a couple of weeks. But anyway, we'll verify it's empty. All the guns on my channel is empty, but you got to make sure. I've also indicated that the double action is pretty heavy. Okay. Single action is not bad at all. It's got to be about 5 pounds. Just real nice. If you're wearing tactical gloves or something like that, at least for me, my old man finger kind of got tore up a little bit when it's a bare finger trying to pull that double action. It kind of cuts into my finger. So some tactical gloves, that cured that all up. but I think it's a pretty gun, even though it's got its little fake ribbing up there, kind of like a python or something like that. But hey, you're getting a 357 Magnum for under $400. That's a pretty good deal, I'd say. Now, of course, this is a 4-inch barrel. And anyway, I had somebody come on and say it wasn't really a 4-inch barrel. I don't know if I've got my measuring device here. Things are kind of a mess. But that's what the manufacturing site says, is it's a 4-inch barrel. Might be a little bit longer since you're coming straight from the cylinder all the way up. I don't know. And I haven't double-checked the measurement. But it weighs just under 2 pounds, 31 ounces. So with that weight, it handles recoil real nice. The grip is very comfortable. It's just a fun gun to shoot, and I plan on keeping it. So that's kind of the take right here, and I'll do a wrap on it here. All right, so we're going to do a little more close in-depth breakdown with this Windicator, EAA Windicator, than the last time I did it when I was just kind of freewheeling it. But anyway, this, of course, is an EAA Windicator, nickel, the 4-inch barrel, 357, can shoot 38 as well. Capacity is 6 rounds. Of course, it's a single action, double action revolver. The sights are fixed. It is a steel frame. It weighs 31 ounces. Double action is fairly heavy, probably about 9 pounds. Single action, not so bad. This has been checked, so it's clear, nothing in it. So, single action. You can stage it back here if you want. It's not as easy to stage as some. Double action, like I said, is fairly heavy duty pull there, 9-10 pounds. Single action. Probably about 5-6 pounds, not too bad. The sights are fixed. You're not going to do any moving on these sights. Front blade, notch rear. Your hammer has some striations on the hammer. The trigger is somewhat thin. And it kind of digs into my finger in double action. I wear tactical gloves when I shoot this thing, and it doesn't seem to be any trouble with that. It's got these fake ribs, like a python or something such as that, a nice shroud. Of course, some people have kind of given these guns a bum rap, saying they're cheap Saturday night special things, and I disagree. This thing feels fairly well built. Took it to the range a couple of days ago. It was extremely accurate. Fired 38 plus 3 plus P and full load 357 rounds with no trouble at all. It has kind of a rubber neoprene grip. The grip is pretty good. Ergonomics are decent. Like I said, it's 31 ounces and empty. It holds 6 rounds. And that kind of gives you up close and personal on this thing. So a lot of the places I've looked at today online, they're out of stock. They're fairly inexpensive gun, especially when you're going for, you know, 357. Even Taurus 357s are a little more expensive than this. So that's kind of my desktop on it. You see it's dirty because I just took it to the range a couple days ago. I'll put that in this video as well.
Windicator a try in a wheelchair, no less. So let me get my gloves on here and we'll be running. Run this thing out. All right, walk this wheelchair down. These are full blowed 357s. Still working on the 550, but that's the first one, and I got those there, so not bad. +38 P. Ooh. How'll that get in there? That's a 10 millimeter. All right. 38 plus P. Here we go. Oh, that obviously 357. What was that? All right. Not a problem. Thing works great.
That one too.
Well, I guess that's not bad from a wheelchair, especially I figured
side pitcher. Put some wire on that. Not bad.
All right, so let's go ahead and do a wrap on this EAA Windicator or Windicator 357 Magnum. I highly recommend it. So far, this thing has been accurate, reliable, and fun to shoot. What more can you ask for? I don't know. Now, I'll probably do a chapter 3 on this thing when I'm able to put maybe another 150 rounds through it. Of course, 357 and 38 ammo are somewhat cost prohibitive, although they are coming down, but if you're looking at getting a cheap 357, inexpensive, I should say, maybe you look at this. Is there a lot of people out on the internet that say they've had good experiences with it? And I'm going to be one of them, apparently, because it didn't give me any trouble. So anyway, as usual, coming to you from deep in the heart of Texas, this is Weapons Tech Mac. God bless Texas. God bless the United States. And long live the Republic.
Carry on my wayward son. There'll be peace when you are done. Lay your weary head to rest. Don't you cry no more.